Let's take these vertices, E, G. Take this and give it some thickness, like that. And pull it back past the 3D cursor. And look at a mirror. So I'm satisfied with that. With this selected, I'm going to take the bisect tool and pretty much make a cut right there. Okay, let's turn off that mirror. So I've cut that. Let's give it a bit more thickness to do this. Put an edge loop right there. Take all these faces. Now, we're going to need to select this vertex and this one, W, subdivide. No, not yet, sorry. I put a face. Now we'll subdivide them. Now we got a vertex there, and we can join that up. And I can press GG if I want to straighten that out. I'm going to join this vertex to this one. And now I can start building faces, that edge and that edge. This edge and this edge. This edge and the one in the middle, this edge and this edge. Okay, now I'm going to start bringing in some edge loops or loop cuts. And we'll need a bunch of these. And we'll just play it by ear as to where I want to put them all. For now, I'm going to do this. And I know I'm going to need to come down here. I think up as well to support that, and I think down here, let's give that a try. On this, get rid of that mirror, just put on a subdivision surface. I'll go for 2, just to look a little bit nicer, and I'm not too worried about this end here, although I suppose I could sharpen that if I wanted to. Well, I'm not going to right now though. So here's what we got. We got this. I'm just going to pull that out here. And I'm going to shift D, rotate Y 180. And then I'm going to pull this guy up until it sort of looks like it fits. And it's going to be good enough. Okay, for what I'm trying to do here. So some of these edge loops have caused my circle to be a little deformed. As you can see, we could go in and, if we were worried about it, it's going to be so small. It up, E and S, and then I'll grid fill that. And grab this and we'll bevel and just put on smoothing. scale it down. Move it back to here. We'll see, it's still probably pretty big. Now, there isn't any scissors in the diagram, but I felt like making them, thinking that it might be a good idea. See how small they are. You know, subdivision surface, it's a lot to do for just that. But I mean, you know, they should look okay. Okay, so we are making some of these tools, so let's do something else here. Let's select that. And let's bring in that circle again. Scale it down. Make a probe. Let's rotate X90. Scale it some more. Extrude. Close off this end, E and S, and then grid fill. Just very simple. E and S. That or anything. I need another one entirely with that. Okay, so I could do that. I could copy this. Make a smaller one. Let's make sure these guys are on the ground. And scissors are large compared to these. I meant to do that. And we'll do one more thing. Okay, let's see. Let's do E. Let's pull it out. We'll extrude it up a little. just the way it is. It's going to be fine with what I'm going to do. Let's take that back, actually. Better do wireframe. Didn't I? Let's try applying that. Making sure I don't have any doubles in there. Let's try subdivision on it. And got over here, we got to face there. Where are you? There you are. Oh, that's the bottom. There you go. That's it. Not the nicest piece of equipment, but it's another thingamajig. Doesn't catch a lot of light, but I'll make it a bit thicker, and that'll be a bit better. Some tools which will be very small. Cool. And it's coming along.